everyone. So this episode was filmed a few weeks ago, so I wanted to take this opportunity to amplify an organization that's been doing really incredible work for our Black trans community. They're called the Okra Project. They provide home-cooked meals and resources to their community, and it's an organization that I strongly support personally. I ask you, I urge you to please join me in learning more about and donating to theokraproject.com. And now, without further ado, a new episode of Show Me What You're Working With. This week on Show Me What You're Working With, we have a super talented artist. He recently lost his job. He's quarantining with his parents in Canada, and I want him to make something super special for his parents. It's gonna be crunchy, it's gonna be caramelized, it's gonna be spicy, it's gonna be sandwichy. I've already said too much.
I'm Antoni, and this is Show Me What You're Working With, Fab Friday edition. You show me what you got, and I make something for you. Don't you
cry. Is that good?
Hello, everyone. Let's do it.
I'm very jacked up on coffee right now.
Hi, Josh. I didn't recognize you without a bandana and with glasses.
Is this how you do it?
Just
give me some guac and we're literally twins.
Yeah, you were looking in a mirror, weren't you?
Okay, you're quarantining with your parents right now. Where were you before?
I was back in Ontario. I'm a musical theater performer. We were in rehearsal and everything was great and awesome. And then Broadway was canceled. Like literally Broadway was canceled. I didn't really have any money coming in. And my parents invited me to come back home and stay with them and, you know, to keep their little baby safe.
Dad.
Yeah, we always do.
Who does the cooking in your house?
For the most part, my mom. I would say like 95%.
Maybe it's like nice to like maybe move that to 90% and make it 10% yours since you have extra time
100%.
And show your mom and a little bit of thanks. So let's make them something.
Let's do it.
I feel like I'm on MTV Cribs. We've got blueberries, fun angel hair pasta. Apparently we're obsessed with mushrooms.
What's above the mushrooms?
They're chicken breasts. We've got some juices, some peri-peri.
I love my peri-peri.
And my parents are South African, so they grew up with Nando's and they just like love it and have passed that on to us and we love it.
What if we made a classic like Nando's style chicken sandwich?
Oh my God, I'd love to. That sounds perfect.
Awesome.
Fun. Yeah.
Go Canada.
Vive Canada.
It was nice meeting you.
Bye.
All right. We're going to make the best damn chicken sandwich ever, and that's a Nando's peri chicken sandwich. Let's do this.
Okay, so the ingredients we'll be needing today, a fresh pineapple, some beautiful, big, fat, juicy tomatoes, a bit of mayonnaise, lemon zest, brioche buns, but you can use ciabatta, baguette, potato buns, whatever you got is fine. A bit of salt, fresh arugula, but you can use iceberg, romaine, literally whatever you have laying around. Some olive oil, some butter, and some chicken breasts or thighs, which have been marinating in my favorite, peri-peri sauce, which is traditional to South Africa. It's made with African bird's eye chili. You can get this at a grocery store. It's spicy, it's tangy, it's awesome, it's good stuff. So our first step, we're cutting a pineapple. When you're picking out a pineapple at the grocery store, you wanna make sure that it's not this green. Nice big sharp knife. We wanna cut both ends off first. And then you wanna go down with your knife and just go all the way down, making sure that no green is left. I wonder if Neon likes pineapple.
Remember what happened with the mango?
Oh yeah. Let's skip it. And now we're ready to slice it. You wanna get this about anywhere between 3/4 of an inch and an inch, because we're gonna be grilling this. Oh, perfect. And now we just wanna get rid of the core on the inside, because this part is really fibrous and rough. And then this piece is ready to caramelize. I'm gonna lay it right on the pan. It is sizzling. A sizzling pineapple. It's not a sentence I ever thought I'd hear myself saying. Here we are.
Nice.
So we just wanna get that same little like nice dark brown char on the other side and we're gonna be good to go. I'm using chicken breast, but you can totally use chicken thighs. They're delicious and they have a lot of flavor. I've marinated these in about 2/3 of a bottle of the peri-peri sauce. I wanna leave 1/3 because I'm gonna be adding it to mayo for a nice special sauce afterwards. I put these in this morning. They've basically been marinating in the fridge, covered with saran wrap, nice and compact so that there's no air for about 4 to 6 hours. The longer you let it marinate, the better it's gonna taste. Okay, so I have a medium nonstick pan on medium, medium high heat. I'm gonna put a little bit of olive oil in the pan and a little bit of butter. It may seem a little weird to put two different types of fat in a pan, but if you just put olive oil, it's gonna burn a lot quicker. And if you just put butter, it's the same thing. basically the burning points of both fats kind of cancel each other out. So you're gonna prevent it from burning. So the chicken's hit the pan, it's sizzling, it's starting to cook, it's gonna get nice and beautiful and crispy. And on that note, let's move on to happy hour. Welcome to happy hour.
So we're all learning a lot about our families, our roommates, our significant others in quarantine. So I thought I'd do five facts I've learned about Antoni during our government mandated time together. And to help me out, I've enlisted in this week's guest, Josh.
Nice.
He doesn't require post-dinner snacks. After dinner, he's literally just done eating, which is something I can't relate to because I need a pint of Halo Top to fall asleep.
That's very true. It's called intermittent fasting. It's a thing that exists.
You're good at it. You are. It's impressive. He always runs with a hat on, and you might be thinking a hat to block the sun makes perfect sense, but he wears it backwards, so I really haven't cracked why it's on in the first place.
Look how much hair I have.
Oh.
Is this what you want? See ya.
He genuinely enjoys cooking and cleaning. He says that he finds it calming, which is perfect because I find both of those activities anxiety-inducing.
But you know what? You're a good taste tester.
I am good at that.
You have strong opinions.
The voice that he uses to talk to food is the same voice that he uses to talk to Neon.
Who's the best carrot in the world? You're the best carrot in the world. Who's the best dog in the world? You want some carrots, Neon? There you go. Good girl.
I didn't know that.
You definitely do.
That's how I talk to little things that I love, I guess. Well, I talk to you that way too, don't I?
No, the voice I get is actually different, which is making me question everything.
Next!
He actually has a massive fear of snakes, which I didn't know until we started living down in Texas, and he's constantly on high alert for where a snake might be. He actually pointed one out that was underwater in a lake.
I lost bandana.
Apparently it was a cottonmouth, and those are extremely venomous.
But the good news is he alerted the entire lake about there being a snake there, so everyone was safe.
That's very true.
We've come to the end of our little show. Thanks to Kevin for the facts, now we all know. He runs with a hat and really hates snakes. Finds peace in scrubbing dishes and takes large meal breaks. It's called intermittent fasting, and it's a thing.
Wow. Thank you, Josh.
And on that note, back to the kitchen. So I'm gonna flip our birds, nice and caramelized and brown and crispy. Perfect. Okay, here's a little pro tip. When you're cooking a chicken breast, if you wanna know if it's fully cooked through or not, it needs to be in between touching your thumb with your middle finger and your ring finger. And if you touch this part of your hand right over here, that's how firm it should be. When you touch your index, that's too soft. That means it's probably still a little rare on the inside. Come look at this. See how beautiful, nice and crispy that is? Glazed with that peri-peri. This is gonna be an awesome chicken sandwich. So our last step before we start assembly, we wanna toast our buns. I have a small pan on medium heat, the same one that I used for pineapple. I just wiped it down with a little bit of paper towel. And then with some room temperature butter, I just wanna go over nice and lightly. This is an extra step that is so worth it because it gets the bun all nice and golden and it prevents it from drying out. And it's gonna be about a minute on each side. Oh, it smells so nice. Beautiful golden brown. I have a bowl with a little bit of mayonnaise and I'm gonna add a little bit of peri sauce, whatever was left of not marinating the chicken in. Beautiful. A little bit of lemon zest. Oh, that's good. And then next up, our arugula. So I'm just gonna actually use a tiny bit of salt and a little bit of olive oil. Just mix that around. And our last thing, the tomato. Tomatoes can be very frustrating to cut. This kind of feels like a PSA. Use a serrated knife. Those teeth are perfect for cutting through the delicate skin of a tomato and not squishing it up too much. Gorgeous, that's our piece right there. And finally, gonna cut through the chicken breast. And I'm basically gonna butterfly it, fully cooked through. All right, so we're ready to assemble our sandwich. So we take our bottom bun and we wanna put a bunch of that peri mayo on. Then we put our grilled caramelized pineapple slice right on top. Okay, let's have a moment. This pineapple is exactly the size of the bun. How great is that? Then we have our chicken slices, a little bit of peppery arugula that we toss in olive oil and salt. And then we anchor it with a beautiful slice of our heirloom tomato. And finally, the top bun. Put even more peri mayo on there. Doesn't that look freaking delicious?
It looks
really, really good. My triceps are about to give out from this camera view, but we've got it.
It's worth it.
Worth it.
Okay, I'm ready for a bite. Can we cut the cameras? I need a moment to myself with this sandwich right now. This is freaking delicious.
On-camera eating could not be any more uncomfortable, but it's really, really good. It's awesome.
All right, Josh, I made my version of the Nando's chicken sandwich. It's time for you to do it for your parents. Now I gotta go because Neon's about to lose it.
Okay, so we've made Nando's chicken sandwich for my mom, who's been incredible for me during quarantine.
Ooh, girl, that's delicious.
So considering this is a South African sandwich, I figured I'd do my due diligence and teach you a little bit of South African slang. So in South Africa, if somebody really likes something, if something's like super tasty, they're probably gonna say this is baie lekker. Mom, do you concur?
Just baie lekker, Antoni. Thank you for teaching Josh the recipe. Nando's chicken's one of our favorites, and now we've got a new one.
Thanks again for the amazing meal. My mom loved it, I loved it. You know, if you ever need a stunt double, you know where to find me. So I hope you guys are doing well, and we'll get through this. See everybody on the other side of it.